Koenig.
Mayor Stocks, members of the council, good evening. I'm Mark Wisniewski. I reside at 2036 Countrywood Way in Encinitas. I am a state licensed landscape architect and a consulting arborist, and I offer my opinion for free this evening. I'd ask the city staff to put up a big portion of the drawing they had up earlier that showed the improvements and an existing tree. The couple things to note when that picture comes up is that the sidewalk is scaled at 4 feet. I didn't bring my scale this evening, but it appears that the tree is represented is probably within 18 inches to 2 feet of the edge of pavement. I visited the site just prior to coming to the meeting this evening and noted that the edge of pavement as it exists currently and the tree is about 18 inches to 2 foot higher than the pavement. So if the pavement is put in as shown, you will have a precipitous drop off and erosion from the tree planting area onto the pavement. Also, all roots on the east side of the tree, starting at the edge of pavement, actually probably about a foot back from edge of pavement because they have to form that. So there's always some construction area. Will be damaged and are removed. So essentially, trees have wide spreading root systems like my arms. When you cut them off on one side, the tree no longer has that structural stability. It also doesn't have the physiological support to continue growth. It's not something you want to do on a large mature tree. Also, the trunk as shown on the tree on the drawing does not appear to be in scale with the actual tree. The trunk diameter on the tree is larger, I believe, than is shown on the drawing, and the buttress root system at the base of the tree would probably extend into the area that's shown by the pavement. So essentially you're cutting right up to the trunk of the tree. The tree would not be saved. It would be compromised severely and structurally compromised so that in case of high Santa Ana winds, it could possibly topple into the power lines. Thank you very much for your time.
Delores Welty, probably the only non-resident from Crest, but I have a friend who lives there who likes to bird. She's an amateur birder just like me, and so she called a guide and set up a party so that they could go somewhere where there were birds. And when the guide arrived at her home on Crest, he said, "Why leave?" And they spent the day birding on Crest Drive. I tell you that to tell you what a treasure it is, a true treasure that can attract that kind of variety, that kind of wonderful nature to this community. I remind you also, I was here when we incorporated, of the gentleman who spoke of his father and grandfather who planted many of the trees on Crest Drive and watered them by hand, and he helped as a young lad too. The idea of widening Crest has come up time and again, and we must not do it. I walk on La Costa to the beach. I walk on Sheridan Road over to Andrews and down to Vulcan. I walk Vulcan and around and back to Sheridan. And there is a little bit of DG where I walk along Andrew because, you know, the Barrett homes are in there. And they had to provide that. But we walk in the street. And let me tell you that even though we walk in the street and there are cars that want to get by, people are generous and kind and they don't even honk. And we are very careful to keep alert to cars and get out of people's way so that they can use that precious street as all of ours. And thank you.
Good evening, City Council. Sheila Cameron. And I live in Lucadia, the only other person on Crest. I support 100% the appellate's position. This subject concerns all communities of this city. The general plan, our constitution, as it stands now, states over and over that community character and environmental sensitivity and preservation trump the application of street standards. Read the general plans, they're over and over. it's even more important than the clothes. The DG Trail, it's interesting. In the general plan, Crest isn't even in the trail survey overlay map at all. And I'm not quite sure when it got stuck in there, but there should have been some thought given to what streets are appropriate for trails and what aren't. I thank Kevin Farrell for shining a spotlight on problems that have come to exist in some departments in this bureaucracy of this city and also in all our communities. There are two levels of things going on here. It's not only what was done, but how it was done. I am aware there's bullying, threats, excessive bureaucratic hoops, misinformation, and misdirection given by staff members to citizens in the city. I know it, and you better wake up and know it and know who they are. I hear stories from all over the city of mean tactics, and it is not the right way to treat the citizens of this city. We founded the city on two precepts: quality of life and community character. Curbs, gutters, and sidewalks was number three. I think all of staff needs to remember and think of the image of the upside down pyramid. The citizens are at the top with the largest and most important voice. The city council and commissioners are supportive in nature and serve the citizens. Number three, at the bottom are the staff who are very well paid, but they are to keep us legal, of course, and to carry out the wishes of the people. That's government by the people, for the people, and that's how it works. Please don't lose sight of this. I'm requesting that a future item be placed on the agenda to clearly address community character, quality of life in the city, and include neighborhood streets and character, and how engineering and planning can actually comply with our community character rather than destroying it. Now that Mr. Farrell and the Backus family have had the courage to open the door, you will hear other people coming forward from all over the city with stories of how they've been treated as well. When I was on city council, I want to tell you, we did away with all IODs. I don't know if you remember this, Jim, but we did it. Those are IODs that you're looking at. That's why you have this awkward setback, no setbacks for 20 homes, setback, no setbacks. We did away with those IODs. We also said that all the older parts of town were to be 40-foot right-of-ways. Now, I've gone through the resolutions, and I can't find it. But those were unanimous votes by the council when I was on there, about 98, 99, something like that. So I don't know what's going on here, but basically you're stuck with IODs, and it clears everything for so many feet in front of your house, and it is ridiculous for an already established street. So I suggest this city council agendize three things: right-of-ways, IODs, and special case streets, and make sure the Crest is on it. But you need to help us all out in the older parts of town. We don't need sidewalks. We don't need unnecessary things, and we don't need to be mistreated by staff. That's all I have to say. Thank you.